So we've discussed sensory memory, working memory, and long-term memory, such as episodic or semantic memory. But how do we get information to our long-term memory? Well, there are four steps to long-term memory formation. There's encoding, consolidation, storage, and retrieval. Let's first start by looking at encoding. So the first out of the four steps of turning information into long-term memory, as we said, is encoding. This means that we intend to new information, we take it in, and then we process the new information. So our brain focuses on something new, takes it in, and we process that information. That is us encoding new information. Now the key here is attend. It's important to remember that we have to pay attention. Attention is what drives the process of encoding. That is, we have to pay attention to and be aware of the information that we're trying to remember. Now there are two types of encoding. One type of encoding is termed automatic processing. As the name implies, it refers to encoding information that occurs with little effort or conscious attention to the task. Remember at the beginning of the lesson when we asked if you remembered what you had for breakfast? This is an example of the kind of automatic processing we're talking about. So although you may have encoded what you had for breakfast this morning, by the evening you may have forgotten it, because it took little effort or conscious attention to the task. The second type of encoding for long-term memory is termed effortful processing. Effortful processing happens when we carefully pay attention to information and try to make a conscious effort to remember the information. For example, the type of semantic memories we have, such as remembering the names of the presidents of the United States or trying to remember the names of all the continents, these involve our ability to consciously pay attention to information and to put an effort into retaining this information. While you take notes for this class or watch our videos, you're engaging in effortful processing because you're trying to retain the information that you've learned. At least I hope so. So how do we go about engaging in effortful processing? Psychologists theorize levels of processing relate to our ability to more deeply encode information so that our recall improves. Let's go into a little more detail about this.